In this screencast, we're going to set up and solve a system of material balances on a liquid-liquid extraction process. Liquid-liquid extraction is a commonly used separation technique where a solute is transferred from one solvent to another. In this particular problem, we have a solute S that's dissolved in water, and the solute is transferred to an organic solvent that's immiscible in water. In other words, the organic solvent and water don't mix. We're given a process diagram below, and if we take a look, we can get a sense of how liquid-liquid extraction works. The feed to the process consists of the solute in water. We have a known flow rate of 200 kilograms per hour and a specified composition. As the solute-rich water phase transfers through the vessel, the solute's transferred from the water phase to the organic phase, leaving us with a product of primarily pure water. The solvent that's been depleted in the solute is known as the raffinate. The other feed to the process is pure organic solvent, which is indicated by the composition variable of 1, and we have an unknown flow rate of M1. The organic solvent is transferred through the extraction vessel and enriched in the solute. The flow rate leaving the process has been given as 225 kilograms per hour, and we have an unknown composition. Because the organic solvent and water don't mix, we know that we only have two species in this stream. The composition variable of the solute has been given a variable of X2, and we know that the composition of the organic solvent is 1 minus that. The solvent that's been enriched in the solute is known as the extract. Given our process diagram, we're asked to calculate two things. Number one, we want to find the organic solvent that's required to produce a water product containing 0.5% solute. So that's indicated by the mass fraction of 0.005s in the raffinate, and we want to find M1. The second thing we're asked to calculate, we want to find the fraction of the solute in the feed that's recovered in the organic solvent product, which is the extract. So of the solute coming in, how much of it ends up in the extract stream? So to do that, we're going to have to find a value for X2. Before we start setting up a system of mass balances and calculating what we need, it's generally a good idea to find out if we have enough information in the problem statement to solve for what's asked for. We can quickly determine whether we have enough information by conducting a degree of freedom analysis. The degrees of freedom for a process is given by the number of unknowns minus the number of independent balances that relate those unknowns. If we look at the process diagram, we can see that we have one unknown in M1, another in the composition in the extract of X2, as well as M3. So we have three unknowns for this particular process. And we know that we can write an independent balance for as many species as we have in the process. In this case, we have three separate species. We have S, we have O, and we have water. With three species, we can write three independent balances. Technically, we can write a fourth on the overall mass balance as well, but the total mass balance on the system is not independent from the species balance, as it can be derived from summing up the species balance for every species in the system. So with three unknowns, three independent balances, we are left with 0 degrees of freedom. In principle, we have enough information to solve for all three of the variables on this process chart. To calculate the two things that are asked for in this problem, we can relate the process variables with material balances. So the principle of the mass balance is conservation of mass, which is what goes in must come out. So all of our mass balances should have the form of N equals out, and we can write one on the total mass balance as well as the three components in our system. For example, the overall mass balance in this case, we have 200 kilograms per hour in the feed plus our unknown of M1, and that must be equal to what's leaving, which is 225 in the extract plus M3 in the raffinate. Looking at the overall balance, we have an equation with two unknowns, so we're going to need at least one species balance to calculate what we're asked for, which is M1. So because we're trying to calculate the flow rate of the organic solvent in, we can use the species balance on the organic solvent, which is we have pure organic solvent in that stream, so we have M1 is equal to 1 minus X2 times the total flow rate in the extract, which is 225. Looking at the balance on the organic solvent, we can see we've introduced another variable, X2, so we'll need one of the other two balances, either S or W. Doesn't matter which. I will quickly write both of those balances so we can see what balances is easiest to use to calculate what we're looking for. With both the water balance and the solute balance written as well, we can quickly look at the system of equations and determine which balances we can use to calculate what's been asked for. So looking at the water balance, we can quickly calculate M3. Doing the calculation, I find a value of M3 is equal to 173 kilograms per hour. With a value of M3, we can then plug that into the overall balance and solve for M1, which is the first thing that we were asked for. Rearranging the overall balance to solve for M1, I get a value of 198 kilograms of organic solvent per hour. The second thing that we were asked to calculate was the recovery of the solute in the extract, so we need to calculate X2. Here we have a choice. We could use either O or S. Doesn't really matter which balance we use. We should arrive at the same answer if we set the balances up correctly. So as a matter of convenience, I will use the organic solvent balance. We just found M1 was equal to 198 kilograms per hour, so the only unknown in this balance is X2. Solving for X2 in this balance gives us a value of 0.12 kilograms of solute per kilogram. So we're one step away from calculating what was asked for, which is the recovery of the solute in the feed in the extract. So mathematically, that's represented by X2, which we just calculated, times the total flow rate of 225 in the extract, divided by what goes in the feed. The mass fraction was 0.14. The total flow rate in the feed was 200. So plugging in our value of 0.12 into X2 and calculating this quantity, we find that the recovery is 0.964 of what goes in the feed is recovered in the extract. So by setting up a system of material balances on this process, we can systematically solve these equations to calculate the process variables that are asked for.